Loops are programming constructs which repeatedly perform an operation or series of operations over and over and over. There are two types of loops, for loops and while loops. One of the key differences between them is that with a for loop, you know exactly how many times that loop is going to perform its operation before it even runs. Some languages do this by creating a variable that will count up to a certain value, and for loops can also be used to iterate through items in a list. That list will have a certain number of items, which will be the number of times the for loop executes. With a while loop, you don't know how many times the loop is going to be executed. Instead, as the loop is running, it's constantly checking and checking for a condition to determine whether or not it should execute one more time. I'll use loops to help me perform a complex operation that I'm very familiar with, doing the dishes. My kitchen is a little bit of a mess, and I want to clean it up before my friends come over. I'll start by loading the dirty dishes from the sink into the dishwasher with a for loop. I know exactly how many dishes I'm going to move from the sink to the dishwasher before I start this task, because there are exactly 3 dirty dishes in my sink. And I won't stop loading the dishwasher until I've completed that task for all 3 of those dishes. So I'll pick up the bowl and put it in the dishwasher. That's one item. Then I'll pick up the plate and put that in the dishwasher. That's 2. And finally, I'll pick up the cup and put that in the dishwasher. 3. Now, after loading those 3 dishes, I've reached the end of my list. And since a for loop operates on each element in the list, I'm done. I'll never load more than 3 dishes because that's how many dishes were in the sink. This is the example script, which represents the process of loading the dishwasher. I've created a list called sink, which has 3 dirty dishes in it: the bowl, the plate, and the cup. Then I use a for loop to iterate through those dishes. For loops can be used to iterate through the items in a list or some other type of iterable object using this syntax. For each iteration of the loop, the named dish will point to a different object in the list and then print a statement to simulate the act of putting that dish into the dishwasher. Just like with function definitions, Python uses indentation to identify the lines of code that exist within a loop. When I run this script, it starts by putting away the bowl, then the plate, and finally the cup. This for loop will iterate through all of the dishes in the sink. It will always do the exact same thing: put away those 3 dishes. I'll never put away more or less dishes than that. Now, using a print statement to say that I'm putting away a dish is not really the same as removing that dish object from the sink. In fact, if I display the contents of the sink list, you'll see that after running that script, the sink is still full of dishes. The program didn't actually remove anything. So let's modify the script so that when a dish goes into the dishwasher, it also removes that object from the sink list. I can do that by using the remove method on the sink list and passing it the dish to be removed. When I save and run the script, the print statements only put the bowl and the cup into the dishwasher. And if I check the sink, sure enough, the plate is still there. So what's going on? Well, what I've accidentally done here is make changes to the list that I'm iterating through by removing objects from it inside of the for loop. The first iteration through the loop grabs the first dish in the list, which is the bowl, and then removes it from the list. Now, the problem occurs in the next iteration of the for loop because it retrieves the second object in the sink list. But the second object in the list is no longer the plate, now it's the cup. When the bowl was removed from the list in the first loop iteration, that caused everything to shift up in the list, so now the plate is in the first position and the cup is second. This is why you should be careful when adding or removing items from a list inside of a for loop that's iterating over the same list. It causes all sorts of confusion. So how can we get around this problem? Well, I need to remove items from the sink list inside of the for loop. So rather than having the for loop iterate through that sink, I'll make a separate copy of the sink that the for loop can use to iterate. I can do that by calling the list function on sink in the for statement. This will create a copy of the sink list that the for loop will use to iterate through, leaving the original sink free to modify as I need to. Now I'll save and run the script. It shows that all 3 dishes were put into the dishwasher. That's a good sign. And if I check the contents of the sink, it's an empty list, which is what I want. The moral of the story is to avoid changing the contents of a list inside of a for loop that's iterating through that list. Create a second copy for the loop to use, and you can do whatever you want to the original list.